Let's see. Hello. Oh, that looks really bright. Is that really bright? Are we too bright today? Mm-hmm. We might need to turn that. Let me see. I'm in the wrong thing here. That's kind of bright, isn't it? See if that helps. There we go. Nope, that's too. One second, we're just gonna adjust. There we go. Okay. Hi, Oompa. Hope everybody's doing well today. Let's see. Let me make sure I got everything here. Okay. I'm gonna just get started. I'm trying to, we're doing a dragon picture today. You know what? Maybe. Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm getting it already. I wanted to do, I don't know what kind of shape this dragon's going to be. It might be too, I might make him closer. I have an idea for a dragon I came up with today. I haven't done a dragon in a while. I did one a little while ago with the knight's one. This is too close. Let's try this again. We're gonna just rough out something here real quick, and then maybe we'll go this way. I want room for his tail. Okay, that'll work. Maybe some little wings. And we're gonna have the knights right here. Okay, looks good. A little tree. That's what we're drawing. I'm gonna move this. Wait, let me see if I can move this a little bit. Right there. Okay. This is our rough sketch. Get my real paper here. We're ready to go. Usually I have these things drawn out. I wanted to go do a little different today. I wanted to start the process from the beginning. So we're gonna do, kind of looking like a dinosaur right now. This is just really light, so you might not be able to see it right away, but let me go a little bit lower. I had too much, that's good right there. I'm gonna put the ground up about there. This is gonna be kind of a bulkier dragon. That's gonna be kind of the funny part. We're gonna put some, this one's gonna have wings. I don't normally, a lot of my most of my dragons don't have wings, so. And, whoop, messed up that. I was gonna try to stream Tuesdays and Thursdays. I was at a company thing on Tuesday, so I wasn't able to do it Tuesday, but we'll try to do it those times. Okay, there's our two knights, there's the dragon. Let's see. Okay, so my idea is this is a this is like a heavy duty, very armored dragon. So he's gonna be pretty beefy looking here, and we'll see how he turns out. I'm not sure what that is gonna entail, but these knights have decided to try to take him down with some weapons that probably are not gonna be to his advantage. Or to their advantage. Let's see. Got big, huge teeth. It's almost looking like. I'm gonna make him like really kind of armor plated here. I want to see what this is gonna look like. I don't want him to look angry. My dragons don't usually. Dragon, a little more beat up. Got his horns. And he's going to be kind of just a heavily armored, kind of big plates of scales on him. Not his whole body, but just like his nose and stuff. We're gonna do this. So. This. Teeth up. Oh, I like that better. Yeah, the teeth up. Kind of. It's looking good. We're just gonna have these random little splotches here, and then I think you'll have like a kind of a big thing of. Yep. This is his hands I'm drawing now. or one of his hands. Or did I just run out of eraser? Let me see if I have another one. We'll use that for now. Wait, I do have another eraser. Not sure where we want to go with the. Yeah, this is good. This is good. This is good. Okay. I'm not digging the mouth just yet. I've got to. And the eyes are too big. There, that's better. I'm gonna go teeth down. That looks better like that. Okay. Much better, much better. You guys are doing well tonight. It's a quiet night, nice and stormy outside, at least here in Utah. We're having a crazy weather lately. Supposed to be nice Saturday and Sunday though, so that'll be good. All right. Wings here. Oh yeah, yeah. It sounded like it was raining outside here pretty good. I don't know. I can. It's kind of sounded stormy. Hello, Adrian, the almighty wombat. Adrian, was it raining outside? Adrian will give us our report here. Thunderstorm clouds. Oh, you probably had your headphones on when the dogs were going outside. I heard the dogs go outside and it sounded like it was stormy out there. Okay, we're just gonna rough in some feet here. Do some little, this is a tree. This is a tree here. These guys are standing on a cliff. Get that in more detail. Big old tail here. You can hear himself typing. Oh yeah, I bet, yeah. I don't think it ever got to snow down here. I mean in the mountains or on the benches, I'm sure it did. I think tomorrow's supposed to snow because or something. It's gonna be fun tomorrow. That little plate looks a little wonky. Okay. Hey, welcome everybody. Those of you who are just joining us, we're just drawing a dragon. Dragon day today. I haven't done a dragon for a while, so I kind of wanted to get back into doing some more for our dragon collection. This one is a This is what you'd call a heavily armored dragon here. He's a big guy. Thanks, Tatiana. I've said it too. We'll see how it goes here. I'll take recommendations on colors. What color is this dragon gonna be? So far we've done orange, purple, green, yellow, gold, a mud dragon, a blue dragon, a red dragon. So we've done a lot of colors. A lighter blue dragon. What do you guys think? It's up for grabs right now. We'll do any color here. All right, so this is going to be where we, essentially what's happened is these knights have tried to shoot this dragon with bow and arrows. That's kind of a big arrow. No, that's about right. It hasn't gone well. So. This arrow actually broke. It hit him so hard and didn't do anything to him. And so we have all these arrows kind of sticking out of his nose. Gray rock with moss. Oh! He should be dark teal gray dragon to match his age and beefiness. Okay. Yeah, you guys are like, that's pretty close. That's pretty close to the same. I think we can go with, I like that. He'll be kind of like, yeah, kind of just a dark gray guy, but he sits around a lot, so he kind of gets the moss growing on him. All right, that's great. I like it. So, this knight, let's see. He's probably getting ready to go for another shot, but then he realized the futility of it. So he's kind of got his bow still here. He's holding a bow. We're just kind of roughing in his details here real quick. Yeah, that was funny. You guys came up with the same idea. That was awesome. Love it. Yeah, gray just like a, because we have the gray rock dragon, but this guy's not a rock dragon. This guy's just a good old armored. We're gonna put these big chunky plates everywhere. And I love doing that kind of painting. This knight, he's trying to figure out why his bow isn't working at all, why it's lopsided. Screw his hand up a little bit here. I knew I kind of wanted to do an armored dragon with the knights having no effect on him whatsoever. I thought let's draw this one in person, because I don't normally do that, and I usually already just have everything ready kind of thing. So Mushrooms? Yes. That'll be good. That'll be good. I really like doing that kind of painting where they're like, we're gonna give this guy a little feathered hairdress thingy. Finish him up here. He's holding some arrows. He's kind of like, what? Why is this not working? Oh, we'll have him have little things here on him, so this guy's got some more arrows in his little quiver. Okay. Deep steel blue tint mixed in with the gray. Okay. We can accommodate that, I think. Having said that, we'll see what we'll go for this, and we'll see what how the colors work out. We've got multiple spots here for different colors, so we're gonna do because we got his armored plates, so maybe he's gonna be kind of a lighter gray, and then or kind of a grayish color, and then we can add in the dark blue on the plates, and that'll help with the oh, it's my chair. Wait, am I in the right chair? Yeah, my chair's squeaking. Sorry. All right, and see, we can make this cliff kind of like overgrown with stuff, and then we can have him kind of match it a little bit, not a lot, but just some little grass ledges here. Can you hear my chair bad? Is it bad? Okay. All right. There's what we got. It's looking good. Looking good. Let's center this up. I gotta wait. Oh, here we go. I'm looking at my other camera here. Oh, we gotta make it. Oh, wait. Let's see. Right about. That's good. We can see the knights and everybody. You can see everything. Okay. Let's go with that. Tape. Oh, that's. I thought that's what you meant, Tatiana. I thought you were worried that Coco was in here crying to be picked up or something. Because that happens. Okay, let me tape this up. We'll get our water and our paper towel, and we'll be ready to go. New episode of Winter Soldier tomorrow. Falcon Winter Soldier tomorrow. How'd you guys like the first one? I enjoyed it. Not much happened. Just set a foundation, I think. But I'm hoping tomorrow kicks it a little bit more into high gear. So, hopefully. Quick drink. All right. That's our water. There's our paints. Okay. Let's get going on this bad boy. I'm gonna put a little bit of purple in the sky. A little too much purple there. Sheesh. I want the sky to be pretty light too, so. What did you miss? We're talking about Falcon and the Winter Soldier. As my brother said, he wasn't sure if he was too interested in Falcon applying for a bank loan. He was just joking around, but. Yeah, I just watched it again. I just watched the first episode again today just to kind of see if I still picked up anything, if I liked it. So I'm good. I like it. I like it. We'll see what happens. I'm waiting for some more action. It needs a lot more action, but I'm still positive or optimistic about it. So. Guy's got some big horns, some big wings. This guy's built for battle. This dragon's built for battle. He's not messing around. He's doing a nice light sky here. Don't want it too much. Ooh, a tropical forest dragon? A dragon on the beach? That could be funny. Yeah, because I've done a snow one. I need to do like a tropical one, huh? I am not, I haven't used the Daniel Smith watercolors yet. One, because I just haven't used that color yet. I might be able to add some of the teal on here. Banana dragon. That'd be funny. Dragon likes bananas. I like that. I like that idea. These are just a mix of all my watercolors, so. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to do this rock, kind of a purplish color over here, just as a base. Oh, a mama dragon protecting the eggs of the babies. See, then I think if the knight showed up and it was a mama dragon and there were some babies involved, that wouldn't. Normally, my dragons are pretty passive. They're not too worried about what the knights are going to do. And maybe they would. Maybe the dragon wouldn't be worried because the babies are so tough. So maybe that's an idea too. In my mind, in my dragon world, the dragons never worry about the knight. In this world, the knights really don't pose a threat to them. You guys have good ideas. You get good ideas. Okay. Let's just do, so let's see here. I want to do some moss. And we're probably going to do a lot of moss along kind of the top edges of his head and maybe like just places where he sits and, you know, along his back, along here, a lot of moss down here, along his tail. He's not gonna disappear. I think my colors are a little washed out tonight. So we're gonna do some moss, and so I think we're gonna do some like kind of bright greenish moss here, and then it'll kind of match this stuff over here. He's gonna be darker. He'll be darker. We're gonna mess with this here for a minute, 'cause I have a big water splotch right there. Oh, great. Now we have a light spot there. All right, we're just gonna kind of actually, I was thinking I was going the wrong direction for this, but I do need to put this in before we put in the before we mess around with any of the other colors, because this has got to be the lightest color on here. It's a little yellowy right now, but it'll change. Don't worry. We're just gonna put in some of this. Oh, I love it if he's got some moss on his horns. A unicorn. Yeah, I need to do a unicorn. I had a lot of fun doing my last unicorn with the knights. It's kind of a mean unicorn. I don't know if I should keep that going. The dragons are kind of passive, but in my world, the unicorns are kind of the jerks that are misbehaving and stuff. He's feeling mossy. I was waiting for that. I was waiting for it. I like doing this because it looks mossy. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Tatiana. Can hear Adrian typing away out there. I think he's Robloxing. Not too much moss on the wings, just a teeny bit. Okay. That's the starting point. We got that. We're gonna do some gray, purpley gray. Let's see here. No, that's, I don't want that red. Let's see how this goes. I was actually thinking about that, Tatiana, today. I was like, I want to do just kind of draw with me. We'll do a dragon or something. We'll talk about the kind of like what I would do for the elementary school kids. I think it would be fun. Okay, this is a little bit bluer, so we're gonna tone that down, but it's okay, we're good. A paint along. That would be trickier, but I think we could do it. You guys think you could handle painting along if I went slow and explained what I was doing? I don't mind. It's you know. It's not going to be any kind of Bob Ross thing. Nope, not me. Watercolors aren't like oil paints, so it's not like I can say, "Oh, get out your brush and do this, and it's going to look like this." That's the nice thing about what Bob Ross was doing, that oil paint, the technique he was using, if you do the brushes, use the same brushes, and you kind of do what he's doing, it would it would more or less look like what he was doing, because he was just doing brush techniques. Mine would look like a blob with a dog. Oh no, we can get you to draw something. I trust me. The watercolor actually is the harder part. The drawing part is, I went to a couple of elementary school classes, and we had some good dragons. Because I would tell the kids, I'm like, listen, you can draw what I'm drawing, or you can do whatever you want. And so some of them would follow along and do what I was doing, and they might not look exactly like mine, but they would look pretty close. And gonna switch brushes here. And then some would do it just their own thing. They would just, like, if I said if I was drawing the head, they would draw their head, but they would do it their own way. And then if I said, okay, now we're gonna draw the arms and stuff, and they would do their version, and then the kids that were trying to copy me would do it like mine. And yeah, there was some that were like, some had really long legs. I mean, it was the same design of dragon, but it would be like, some would have long legs, some would have short, stumpy legs. It just depended on what the kid was drawing, and that was the part of the thing that I was trying to teach the kids, is it didn't matter if theirs looked a little different, it was still okay, it was still good, and they still drew. Okay, got a cat circling the I don't think she's gonna jump up here though. Okay. Let's put in some gray. That does look exactly like the sky. Some flowers. I thought about having hold arrows. Let's see. Let's get some what are we doing? Deep teal blue, steel blue. Let's try this new color. This is really bright. This is really bright. Let me one second. That color is a little too bright. It's a gorgeous color, but it's it is disappearing. It looks much more. I think I went too bright on my cameras today because it's not that bad, but it looks like that from here. I'm looking at it going, oh boy, we really came in there pretty close to the sky. It's all right. It's all right. This is the first layer. We'll get some shading in there and stuff. It'll look good. Oh, this blue's gonna actually work to nice kind of match that green a little bit. Yeah, we'll do a draw along thing. At least a draw along, a paint along. We'll give it a whirl and see what happens, and maybe we might have to do that like a two part where we talk about how to control the watercolor first. Watercolor is just a matter of control, really. It's not That's like the hardest thing. I did a class. Tatiana was there. I did one class, and I thought, you know what? I'm just going to go buy a simple Crayola watercolor set. I might have told the story. No, I feel like I told the story. I'm going to buy a watercolor set from Walmart. It's just a Crayola brand, like you used to get it in elementary school, and I'm like going to show the kids. It's just a matter of just get the watercolors, and if you control it, it'll work better. Ugh. That stuff, I had no... It was bad. It was not controlled at all. Oh, thank you. Okay. You like the blue? Good. It was a nightmare. I mean, I controlled it as best I could, but the colors would come on the paper like super bright, just no control over the... Those suckers got wet and they just took off in vibrancy. I couldn't believe it. I was like, well, never mind. We won't do that again. But it was still kind of funny. Tatiana was kind of watching. She knew I was in trouble. She knew that color, those paints were not... I should have practiced with them a little bit, to be honest. I went in with them like fresh. I didn't even try them out before I got there, which was my bad. But I would have not done it because I would have said, oh, never mind. These aren't... I got another set too, didn't I? I don't remember where I was. I went to a school up in Harriman, I think, and I had another set there I tried, and I struggled with that one too, so. I have some nice watercolors here, and some I have a harder time controlling because it just depends on how loose they are, how. I'm going to put some scales over there. Doop, doop, doop. Okay. It's a little bit more vibrant. I'll try to, once we're done, we can kind of hold it up to the camera and see. Let's see. His tummy, we're going to do probably like a yellow, like a pale yellow. Let's try this new yellow we got. Tatiana got me some new watercolors. This kind of looks like the moss, but the moss is going to turn kind of green. I got these new watercolors, and they're really nice. But I've only got two tubes so far because I was just testing them out to make sure, because we bought some off Amazon. We wanted to make sure they were the real deal. But I like them. They're good. That's true. That's a good idea. That's a good idea. I have a variety of watercolors here that I'm using as far as like where they came from. I've used the stuff that I primarily used when we started doing the whole thing was just a basic set from Hobby Lobby. I think it was, I mean, we got kind of the bigger set that was like, I think it was like $20. But they had like smaller sets of the same kind that were, you know, $8, $9. And that, I mean, that's the thing, they last a long time. But now I've got kind of a mix. I've got some from Tatiana's parents from Russia. And you can get those on Amazon too, but they're pricey too. But yeah. No, yeah, it's not expensive. My paper, or the kind of paper you can get is pretty much anywhere you can get it. The paper that I use. Hobby Lobby, Michaels. Walmart had it for a while. They haven't had it for a while. Wondering if they're going to get it back. I don't know what happened. I kind of jumped on the dragon here. We're going to hit this little rock formation here really quick. Well, maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll do a just paint along series. For sure we'll do draw along. For sure we'll... I want to do something where we draw something. But. Okay. We've got some base colors in there. The knights are kind of sitting here. We'll give them a little bit of color here, just so they're not left out. But. Okay, and I think we're gonna do the wings, the dark blue too, or at least kind of a darker grayish blue color here. We'll get some more color going here once we start adding the detail and stuff, but. Yeah, I think it'd be fun to do a draw along. I think people would have fun with that. The hard part for me is I like seeing what people are doing. It's not so I can like critique them. I just want to see how I like seeing what other people come up with doing the same thing, like when we're all drawing together and stuff, and it's really fun. That was like my favorite part of watching the kids draw. Is to see, like, to walk around and see what they were doing, because they just all take off doing their own thing, and it was just so much fun. I loved it. Okay, we're going to go in and we're going to start darkening up stuff here now so we can differentiate between the sky and... So usually when I'm doing the dragon's skin, I'm kind of being a lot more splotchy with the paints, because I want them to be rough, and I add color a lot. I don't worry about if it's darker or lighter. It just adds more texture to the dragon. Now you can see now it's starting to blend in with his scales a little bit, because it's... We're darkening those tones a little bit, but I like it. Now, see if I say okay, just be splotchy with your paints. I don't know. Maybe people will be like, "What do you mean?" Splotch. I use two brushes usually, unless I'm doing something really different. I used to use a lot more, but I got two that were just kind of my go-to brushes. This little guy. This guy's number two, and this flat brush, number 10. And then I have one more that's kind of the same thing, but it's a little bit stubbier. Number 8. I kept with the 10 because I could load it up easier. Yeah, see, that's the thing. You just I tell you, the funnest thing I love painting is doing this stuff. That's why when you guys were like, add grass and moss and stuff on the dragon, I'm like, oh yeah, I'm down for that, because that's... It's so much fun just adding that, because when you have the control and when you have the textures and stuff going, it just... You can't do any... You don't do any wrong, and it's just fun. It just makes it so much fun to paint. When I first started out, people would ask me which one was... Like, which painting did I, like, do the most, and one of them was Boba Fett, because he was just... His armor was all just dirty and mottled and beat up. So I love doing that. I love doing that kind of painting. Let's see. I'm going to do a little bit of... We're doing a little bit of shading here. We're bringing out some light here and stuff, but okay. I'm trying to make sure we don't go too long here. We've gone about an hour. This has actually been a lot easier to paint than Scarlet Witch and Vision last time, because Vision and those guys, because I had to like make sure it was looking like them and you know, getting the colors, and also it was my first time painting for a while and my first time streaming in a while, so I had all these emotions and anxieties and things running through me, and I was like trying to make sure it looked good, and so I was going really slow, and I'm glad I didn't draw that one on stream because I would have been a basket case. Hi, Sasha. Bob, Steve. This dragon? Ivan. Have you been here the whole time, Sasha? Oh, thank you for watching. So let's see, I'm on one thing. We got Oompa, we got Tatiana, we got. Yeah, that's about five. Oh, you were doing horror. Oh, okay. Well, I'll take it. I'll take whoever wants to watch. I'm happy. Happy to have you all here. It's actually nice to talk to somebody while I'm painting too. Okay. We've got a mottled mess. It's coming out nicely. We're gonna come over here to this stuff because I want to start working our way across here. We're gonna start getting fingerprinting stuff on everything, so we don't want that, but let's. You know what? I want some brown in this rock too. We don't want it the same color as the dragon. Rupert's good. Rupert's a good name. Rock is also, like when you're doing rocks, that's pretty hard to mess up if you're painting rocks. You can do it, but it's, you know. I think the hardest thing to teach people is when they're drawing or painting, it's just kind of like relax about it being perfect. Because especially watercolor, it sometimes does what it wants to, and you just have to be like, "Hey, that's okay." Rupert, okay, we'll call this one Rupert. I should do that for all of the dragons. We should have names for them, and then when people ask for them at Comic Cons, they can have little name tags by them, so they can, I. Then they can ask for which dragon they want by name. Although then we would forget which one was which, probably. But this guy, I think, will be known as Rupert. I think that's good name. How would they know by name? We put little names by them. They still wouldn't call them by their names. They'd probably just say, Give me that green dragon. I know, it wouldn't work. Okay, that's looking pretty good. We'll add some more shadow there in a minute. Let's get these knights polished up here. Coco. Bless you. I don't know who that was. Sneezing. Sorry, I'm like totally putting my arm around this. I just realized. You guys are like, we can't see. Is that better? I'm working on getting a third camera for up close shots like this so you guys can really see what I'm doing, but I haven't quite got it working yet, so. Adrian, I can hear you, but only because I can hear you. Like, it, I don't know. I don't think it's picking up on the microphone. Bob and Steve. The Knights. Let's add some little dings on there. Let's see how those turn out. Those aren't turning out. I don't have enough paint. Too wet. Yes, I can. Can you really hear him? He's pretty quiet, but that'd be funny. You probably just hear it like a little mumbling noise. You're fine, Adrian. It's very quiet. Alright, sorry, my arm's in the way here. This is the portion where being left-handed becomes a bit of a detriment. Yes, you can do your Zoom quietly. Sasha and I went to a little golfing thing last week and they were asking us, is anybody left-handed? And Sasha and I are both left-handed. Tatiana's left-handed anyways. And we're like, yeah, we are. And they're like, both of you? And it's just funny to me that people are still like, being left-handed is still like a thing to be like, what? Like, of all the things, it's like, yeah, there's, it's left-handed. Anyways, it's kind of funny. All right. Okay, we're going to try out this new blue. Here we go. You know what? I'm going to put it on here, but we're going to darken it because it really pops. This is my new blue teal color I bought. And we'll darken it up, but it really pops. You're right-handed, but your left-handed is dominant. Oh, wow. Oh, man. Yeah, my colors are really desaturated a little bit. I'll have to work on saturation. It looks pretty good there, that blue, but it's pretty bright. So. Yeah, I know you like it. It's a very happy blue. But it's like gonna draw the eye away. Oh, that's really thick and dark. holes. I don't know which one of my paintings, but when I first started doing these, when I do these dots, sometimes they flip to the top. And then I would realize that, oh wait, the knight's looking out of the slit. That's where he's looking, and the holes are for his breathing. And I was putting the holes on top of the slit, and I'm like, that's not where he looks at. I don't know which of my things where I did that, but I know I did it on a couple of, at least one of my things. Had one of my knight's pictures, the holes are on the wrong side. I was kind of like, oh, I need to be careful of that, because we're just adding some shadow. So, just giving it some detail. Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's a gorgeous. It's one of those colors that I've always wanted to be able to paint, but I've never been able to really figure out how to mix the right colors to get it. It's one of my weaknesses in color creation, I guess, is trying to get colors to match up like I want. But and then I realized a lot of artists that I was watching just had the colors they needed. They didn't worry about mixing, because I've just always like mix colors to get stuff, you know. I was like, wait, these guys are just buying the exact color. Like the one I definitely don't want to, that I'll buy is like skin colors. I don't want to have to mess with that, because that's tough. I mean, it's, you know, a little blue, a little orange, a little yellow, white, but if I can avoid having to try to get that down. That's kind of cool looking. I'll just do a little bit of shading on this grass, just because it's a little bit too flat. Plus, I kind of want to mirror this look for the moss when we start doing the dragon, so I just want to make sure this is going to look right. I thought of having some music playing, but I don't know exactly how to do that either. Especially on YouTube, you know, they're a little bit more. Well, I was going to say, Twitch has got a lot worse with their copyright stuff, but I want to be able to replay these. You know, that kind of modeled that grass up a little bit. Okay, we're gonna leave the grass alone for now, because that kind of backfired a little bit. It's not right where I want it, but that's okay. It's a little bit more of a mess. We'll fix it. Here, we're just gonna do this real quick, because it's. I don't know why, it just kind of got really, I didn't want it to be blotchy, but it's, there it goes. Okay, that's a little bit better. There's some little trees down here I'm going to do. Oh, let's do this. This is our bright yellow. This is my other color I got. Like a nice little yellow. We need to add, we've got a pretty, everything's kind of the same color right now, so I'm going to add in some other colors. Just to give it some warmth. It's a pretty cold picture right now, color-wise. We haven't even done the ground, sheesh. Just sitting there. Yeah, I think so. YouTube actually has a bunch of royalty-free stuff. I just don't know if I can use it for live streaming yet. It's literally just like learning to do some of this basic stuff first, and then I was like, oh, we'll work our way up to music during the stream. I posted on my YouTube channel a time lapse of the Disney World painting I did, and I found some longer pieces of royalty-free music. The movie itself is about 1 hour and 10 minutes, so I just strung together some very similar. It was all by the same artist. Just ambient music kind of to go along with that, so that it would just kind of be a relaxing thing you could watch. That painting, the Disney World, and probably the Disneyland probably took similar time, but it was 12 hours total time when I just put it together without speeding it up, and then I sped it up 1,000 times. And it came in 1 hour, so. Okay. We're not too shabby here. We're clicking along. I have a, oh, where's my pen? We have these, I drew these little, I'll show you these really quick. I drew these little animals to go along with my fabric line that just came out. And they're not the same, like they look different, but these are pretty simple shapes that we could like probably do a draw along, and it wouldn't be too hard for people to draw this. And then maybe we could paint them and, you know, have fun with that. But because I think I did a bear. Yeah, this is the bear, like, just non. It kind of looks a little sad, actually, but, anyways, yeah. We make a smileier bear. Okay, we got to get going here. We've gone 1 hour. Let's get going here. Let's get this guy finished up. We still gotta darken up a bunch of stuff on the things, get the moss looking good. We're just gonna darken up his. I like where the gray's at. We just need to add some shadows. And then we need to darken all of the big armor plates. So we're gonna do that now. And it should be awesome, and we should be. That's a little too wet. My key for watercoloring is to use as little water as possible. Get you more control. Now, that's not the traditional way to do watercolor, but that's what I do. Probably because not having that control is kind of the hard part of watercolor, but. Thank you. I'm kind of going fast. I'll slow down a little bit because I don't want to ruin the picture, but that's pretty normal for me.
It's amazing. Not really.
The longest paintings I've done were the Disneyland, the Disney World, and Howl's Moving Castle took about 3 nights of just working on it a little bit at a time. I'd probably paint for 1 hour or two.
I know, it's such a quick little view. Oh, I have a police car. Can I just do my track chizzy? I'm going to pull over.
You can see, like, the paint
No, it's the baby.
Kind of pulling up here on this one. You can literally take the paint when it like blobs up and take it in your brush and move it to another spot. It's pretty cool. Then when I've got too much there, then I'm like, okay.
There's still one over me.
We'll probably darken up the gray one more time, but we got to get these in and then start doing mossier colors and some other colors on him just to, he's kind of flat right now, so. A little bit flat, we'll get him. Oh, and the wings, let me do that before I forget, because I'm going to forget and then get done, because it'll be like, his wings. I just kind of want it to be yellow a little bit in there. We might go over it with a little gray just to tone it down and make it match the outside of the wings. But and his horns and claws will be a different color. His teeth too. So. Oh yeah, the Harry Potter ones did take a while. I don't think I did those in one night. I don't think I did. No, I know they did. They took a couple of days. Because one, I knew I was doing a bunch of them, and two, I didn't want to burn myself out too fast on those guys, because, oof, that was an undertaking. I loved doing them, though. They were really fun. I might adjust one of those too, because I had a plan for one of them, and so when I was drawing them, I would have all these details from the books and movies going through my head, and I would kind of take some notes a little bit about what I wanted to make sure was in the picture, but like I would think of it sometimes when I wasn't by my desk or when I wasn't drawing it. And so I'd have these ideas, and I'd be like, oh, that's a perfect idea, and I'd do it. And, you know, most of them I got in, but one detail I didn't get in, and I don't want to go redo it, but. Oh, thank you, Oompa. So the one detail I was going to do on those that I didn't do was on Chamber of Secrets. I wanted to paint Hermione as the cat version, and I got done and moved on from another painting, and then I realized I'd forgotten to do her as the cat. I just did a regular Hermione, and it looks fine, but I just thought that would have been so cool. I know now you're gonna be like, oh, that's how I am. I'm like, do I redo it? Do I add her in just after? But then everybody's gonna be like, oh, you get the cat version anyway. I probably shouldn't even told that story. Because it was just one of those things I was just like, oh, I forgot that. That's the only thing, really. That's the only thing. I mean, I had lots of details I wanted to add into them, obviously, but that was one of those things that I really kind of went, God, I didn't remember. Okay. Oh, I could do a standalone cat Hermione. That would be good. That's a good idea. I need to do a new Hermione. I did a new Harry. Let's see. What am I doing? We're going to do the mossy green stuff here. Let's see how this looks. It's not quite. I need the magic of the yellow ochre. I need this to be like a really kind of, one second, we're just We're toning down the green here a little bit. For. So we're just gonna play with it here. Maybe I need to go to this one. It's kind of blending in with my blue a little bit, so we'll just see how this goes here. It's not working. We're okay. Kind of looks like moss, but it kind of looks like there's just this grass growing on his head. I'm just trying to get it so it looks. See, that's the part I knew was going to cause me trouble. I was like, this will be interesting to see how this works. But we got it. We're fine. There we go. I'm just going to kind of drizzle the... There's a little too much yellow, actually, is the problem, is that the yellow's fighting with it, so it's like, what is that? So I got to get kind of rid of this yellow a little bit here. And then I'm just kind of stringing it down his nose and stuff. And then we'll just add in some nice little shadow on the grass and stuff. Just trying to find a perfect mossy color here that I like. See, that's too bright green right there. Too bright. On the white, it looks fine. But we need it to. I like it. It's gonna work. Oh, hi everybody. Sorry, there's more of you in here now. We are painting a armored annoyed dragon. Hope you guys are all having a nice evening. Thanks for stopping by too, everybody. I know there's plenty to watch on television. So it's nice that you'd stop by and watch me paint. Did any of you watch the new Justice League? I did. I enjoyed it. Is it looking okay, Tatiana? We're getting there. This moss is throwing me a little bit, but we got it. It's no problem. I watched the Justice League twice. I watched it once by myself, and then I watched it with my daughter, and it. I liked it. Did it need to be 4 hours? No. You know, some of the scenes just, like they do, they go long. I can see why they just kind of let it go, because it was just like, you know, hey, knock yourself out kind of thing, you know. was it? I don't think it was as good as Avengers, any of the Avengers movies. It did a lot better at explaining a lot of stuff, and they got rid of all the confusing stuff, I thought, for the most part. So yeah, that's my review. I will put that on when I need a 4 hour distraction. It'll be a nice something else nice to put on. I usually put on Marvel or something if I need a distraction while I'm painting or something, but it wasn't. It's so tough. It's so tough because Marvel's raised the bar so high with their movies that it's kind of like, I mean, even X-Men were, looking kind of dismal compared to Marvel, and that was X-Men. They used to be the stuff, so it's like, you're gonna bring your A game. You got to be as close to as good as that, otherwise it just comes off as, mediocre. Honestly, like if the Marvel movies didn't exist, that Justice League movie was like good. You would have been like, hey, cool superhero movie. But he is looking. Okay, we're gonna just do some stuff now. We're gonna add in some. He's not even close to being done. Can hear my guys laughing back there. I'm just adding in some detail now. So we're gonna just add in some stuff here. I'm liking him. He's looking good. Okay, so like here, I've only used like yellow. I've just used yellow. I've used a darker yellow and a lighter yellow. So it's fine, but it's kind of flat. So I'm going to add in some other colors in here just to give it some a little bit of burnt sienna. This is a lot of burnt sienna. Just to give it some depth, give it to some. I like that. Let's see. I need some very dark gray, bluish color here because he's still a little flat. I don't know if you guys can tell that. He's on my screen, on your screen he's probably really flat. On mine he's not as flat as he looks like on that thing. Sorry, my arm's in the way. Something's happening at my house. There's laughter. I'm not sure what's happening, but it's okay. Okay. And we're going to just go along here with the moss and like kind of put a shadow so it kind of. Makes that like on his head stand out a little bit just so it's kind of like, oh, there's a thing here. It's almost the weekend, guys. Almost the weekend. I'll probably start doing some more paintings that aren't on stream just because I need to start upping my number of paintings I have done just to get ready for cons. That's to say, I might still jump on randomly and just say, hey, I'm painting now if you want to watch. But right now my plan is to do Tuesdays and Thursdays for streaming. Because I kind of got on or it today, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna stream tonight, and I'm like, what am I painting? And What are we doing? How's this gonna work? Am I ready to do another one already? That should look a little better to you guys. Yeah, see, that's just some little dark shadows and stuff here that we're missing. Just, this is supposed to be armor, so it's kind of supposed to be kind of popping off his skin a little bit, and it wasn't, and he was looking a little flat and dreary, and this moss stuff. We're gonna do a lot more mossy color on him here in a second, so get ready. This is a shadow, his arms right there. That wasn't popping enough. Just bringing out the layers, people. What else did we watch? Like, there were so many nerdy things going on last week. Okay. It's looking good. I'm happy with this. Little shadow on his leg. He's got these big claws here too. I haven't even shaded in his hands really there. He's got these big hand claw thingies here. This whole leg needs to be a completely different shade because it's like over there. Yeesh. To say that I'm out of practice a little bit is I will paint like a whole bunch, or when I was in the thick of it going to cons and we were doing shows and we started doing this, I was painting almost every day. And I did one weekend, I did 6 paintings in one day. I just pushed myself and I just, you know, had a lot of stuff I wanted to paint. So I kept painting just all the time, and it was fun. It was good, and I'm glad I did it. And but then what would happen is I'd go to a show, especially when we started going all over the place to shows. Like we'd do Salt Lake, and it was like, okay, we could take a little break. But then we started traveling, and so my time to be able to paint became less and less. And it would be so hard to get back into it, and just the motivation to start painting again sometimes was just oof. And then I'd have my creative blocks where I just didn't know what to paint, which this last year has been really hard. It's not even that I would sit down and try to paint something that I would be like, I don't know what to paint. It was before I'd even sit down, I was like just trying to think in my head, well, what's gonna motivate me to go sit down at the table and start painting? And I had nothing. I couldn't think of anything I wanted to paint. And so it was almost like a creative block of just even the motivation of going and sitting down and doing it. I couldn't even think of what I wanted to paint. And we've painted, you know, over 400 pictures now, so obviously, like, I don't want to start redoing everything and coming up with the same thing. And even though we're retiring a bunch of stuff that's kind of older stuff, when we go out, you know, I'm hoping to have new stuff. But yeah, this last year, it's been difficult for so many reasons. This is a very interesting, this is this dragon, he's a different one. I tell you what, I like it. He's not my normal color palette. He's kind of like rough. He's a lot more rough and tumbled than the other dragons I've done. He is like a little tank dragon, just kind of beat up. And we're gonna make this one more in a shadow here. Okay, so I'm gonna make those insides not yellow because that looks a little bit too glowy. 90 minutes, we've reached the hour and a half mark, people. Thank you for sticking with us. For the record though, I mean, thank you for watching and sticking through this whole thing. We did have to draw this guy first, so normally lesson learned if we want to go for an hour. I don't want to keep you guys for like a long time, so I'm not rushing or anything, but I also want to like keep these to around an hour and a half just because it's a lot. But we did draw this guy, so we did. You guys got to watch this one from beginning to end, which is normally what you don't get to do, so that's fun. We're gonna try to do this a little bit like this. I know it's gone pretty quick and smooth. I have a little timer here that shows, you guys probably can watch it too, or see the timer too, but it's just funny because I just kind of get like, whoa, that's a long time. But I mean, if you're watching, it doesn't seem like that because you're watching me paint, so you're watching paint dry.
Literally.
Okay. That's still a little too yellow, but we're not going to worry about that. I want to do a little color on these, horns and things. Not that much color, but some color. Whatever this color is. Okay, there's that. I'm gonna get a little bit of color on his teeth. Aren't really standing out there as much as I want. Okay. Let me look it over here. I feel like he just doesn't have enough detail on his like, there's just too much flatness. I'm going to just put some little dots and stuff to what I need to do is do the eye thing, because I can't tell if he's this is helping though. This is like giving him a little some fine detail. He just didn't have any like fine little detail. It's like lots of splotch and stuff here, but not enough like of this stuff where it's just like, you know. And I want to add some just green patches, like there we go. That's more what I was, just a little bit of character. And now we're gonna just, I need to find a nice, yeah. Yes, this is what we were missing. Just some nice little green. There we go. Okay, he's coming alive now. He's coming alive. this guy's a lot different. He's got a lot of character and a lot more depth than some of these other guys. Yeah, there we go. Oh, okay, man. That's what it needed right there. That's what it needed. Just, I thought he needs some, like the moss is all over. It's not like just on his things. It's, it's almost like another color of the scales because it's like just embedded everywhere. This is going to get really dark down here. Oh yeah, there. Thank you. Thank you. The arrows. Oh, yeah. That's the whole comedic bit of this thing. Gotta get those. Okay, let me add a little bit more color here to the this. We'll come back to that. I need to darken up the end of his tails. I always make the tails darker. Okay, let's. Okay, here we go. We're gonna let's get some nice dark brownish, blackish color here. Maybe this. All right. Arrows. See if you can see what I'm doing. Just barely. I'm gonna try to scoot my arm over. Oh. We'll do this little blue color as kind of the feathers. Kind of like that's their identifying way of whose arrows are these. I love this blue, but I was worried it was gonna pop too much, and it's like drawing away the eye, but it just gives that nice little punch to the picture where it's like, oh, that's not. There, now it matches the dude's. Now it matches the dude's plumage. Feather thingy, whatever this is called on his head. Just gonna put in a little bit more shadow on that thing too, because it's a little flat. Okay. Oh wow, he's looking great. Okay, I'm happy now. I was a little nervous there. He was a little bit, he's where I wanted to be, but I didn't feel like he was like up to the level as my other dragons for some reason. I couldn't figure out why. He just wasn't quite nailing it. Now I'm really happy with it. He's kind of messy, but I kind of like it. He's kind of like this just almost like he's been sitting there. Nobody's been bothering him, and finally somebody decided to try to. That's not green enough for the moss. A dragon with a castle on its back, kind of like your cupunk turtle. Oh, that's a good idea, Adrian. That's a great idea. Maybe it's some dragons that realize they just need to be friends with them instead of trying to fight them all the time, huh? Go. Excellent, 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 excellent. Okay, we're looking good. We're not quite there, but we're getting close. On the wings, this is like more moss. I need to add some more green to it, but he's got a little bit. Oh, down here, this is that's like on the wings. That's like yeah, that's like he's got some holes in his wings. He didn't really use them for flying anymore. Prefers to stay on the ground. Adding. I know that's really dark. Just give me a second. We're gonna just flesh that out a little bit. Go. Okay. I need to darken up the ground a little bit. It's a little bit too light. I want him. He's throwing down a pretty big shadow here, so we're gonna just do this. Give it a little pop of color underneath him. Oh, thank you. I really like him. This has kind of been a fun one because he's not what I expected him to turn out like. Actually, he's not like I didn't know what he was going to turn out to be like at all because I usually I have an idea of what color he's going to be and stuff, and you guys pick the colors. So now it's just kind of like been like shooting from the hip on this one just to see what he would turn out to. So that's been kind of cool. I didn't think about it like that either, is the fact that like normally I literally will sit down and say, okay, he's going to be this color dragon, and once I decide which color, then everything else kind of just falls into place. But when I haven't really decided anything about the colors until as we're painting, that really changes up the dynamic of how it's going to turn out. But I like him. I'm going to just do, you know what? Okay. Let me, I just want to add a little bit more. These trees are just, I'm just adding a little bit more green down here. Doesn't really need it, but I just feel like, okay. I'm going to do a little inking. I want to see what it looks like here, and then we'll see if we need to do any extra stuff. And we're going to just move the water back here. Okay, I'm going to try to do this so you guys can see, but I'm not making any promises because, actually, this is good. I was going to say, let me untape it, but I might have to make some adjustments. Do the knights first, and then we'll go in and do the dragon. I'm doing an extra fine pin here just to get this detail here. I miss doing knights. We've done so many of them. I miss doing my dragons and my knights. Oh yeah, you can see that. Okay. I've got my screen, like I said, up close here, and it's a little bit more delayed, so I'm not sure what I'm showing. So I had to look over at my other main screen to make sure you guys can see a little bit at least. I think this guy is contemplating if his bow's working. I think he's contemplating if he should even be using it. Giving it up. Doesn't work against the dragons. Oh, thanks, Oompa. Yeah, it does make a... It's... I paint with the inking in mind, so, you know, it helps bring out a lot of the values. I've done a few paintings without inking that turned out, you know, that I like, but the inking's part of my process, and it helps. I think it makes it look great. Okay, here we go. Let's see what dragon looks like when we get them all inked up here. I'm going to use just, this is like not really that much thicker, but it's thicker enough that it'll... Now see, now, like before, it was like, oh, it's just a dragon. It looks like a, now you put the eye in and all of a sudden it's like, boom. There's the there comes the personality. There he is. He just all of a sudden he's there. Like up until that point, you're kind of like, oh, yeah, it's a dragon. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh. I was trying not to make him look like a too grumpy, but he's a little bit grumpy, I think. He is not happy. That's like a plate. I'm going to make it a tooth. It's a long tooth. Yeah, he does not like having arrows sticking out of his nose at all. Oh yeah. Yeah, he's here. He's here now. I'm gonna use a different pin on those arrows because this one's just a little bit. And see, now I can do a little bit more detail on this moss too, where it's just like grass on them, so it pops it. It probably did. He probably got woke up. I kind of think of my dragons as kind of like more like cats, where it's like they like to sleep. They don't want to be bothered necessarily. Oh, this guy's. You know what? Thank you, everyone. This has turned out really fun. I really like this guy. He's kind of, man. And yeah, okay. You know what? Little touch and go there. It's kind of like when I had to paint, when I tried painting Toothless, man. It was like, whew. A little too much. There we go. Sorry, I can hear hijinks going on in my house, so I'm kind of laughing at what I'm hearing, so. It's very quiet, but it's just funny. Come on, little pin. Don't give up. We're almost done. Let's get his wings drawn in here. This pin's like having issues. I'm gonna switch to this guy. Okay. Oh, man. What's his name? What do we call this guy? It's okay, Tatiana. Rupert. He's Rupert. That's right. That's right. Oh, I like him. I like him. Thank you, guys. Sorry, you almost got it before me. Oh man. Oh, I like Rupert. I like Rupert. He is awesome. Some grass and stuff in here under him, so he's just to give it some character down here. Okay. I wanted to do the arrows a little more. Sorry if you can't see what I'm doing. I'm just putting a little detail on the arrows. Just lightly, but I usually don't ink the backgrounds, but yeah, it was not a disaster really. Okay. Looking for something. Averted is the key word there. I'm just inking in these trees a little bit. I don't normally ink in the backgrounds, but I don't know. I usually just ink like the characters and then I leave the backgrounds, but I'm just, for whatever reason, this one I like to, I don't know. It's a different kind of picture. It's really, I'm just scooting back to look at it. Wow, he is something else. He is something else. He's probably the grumpiest dragon I've done. He's probably the grumpiest one. Okay, guys. I think I'm happy with it. I love the colors. I love the, you know, and these knights, he's not particularly a big, I mean, he's big, but he's not like ginormous, but he's just so stocky and grumpy looking. Anyways, we are going to call this one good. I am signing it, sort of. Oh man, my signature just went wrong on that one. Okay. Done. Pens down. Awesome. I love it. Our disasters have been avoided. Thank you. I'm looking at the camera now. Thank you, everybody, for coming, for watching me. I will try to be on Tuesday, and we will just see how it goes. I'm not going to stress too much about it, but thank you for watching again, and thank you for your input, and I think it turned out great. I'm going to just pull it off here. I want to hold it up for you guys really quick before I go, just so you can see it up close. It is a little bit more vibrant. I'm going to try to make sure my colors are a little better next week, because it's a little bit washed out. It is a little bit brighter, so I'll post it. We'll get it scanned in and everything, but there. I don't know if that's going to be too close. Anyways. He's so cool. All right. Thank you, guys. Have a good night, and I will see you next week. All right, bye. I gotta figure out how to end this now. Thanks for watching, guys.